Hey everybody, Claude Diamond here, and a rainy Rocky Mountain Sunday. I wanted to share a little story with you. Even mentors make mistakes. I've written 9 books on sales and real estate, writing a new book on marketing and gut 6.0, and had a prospect call me. This was 2 weeks ago, and real good conversation. Claude, I've watched your videos and everything, and we need help with our sales in our company. And I said, that's great. And I went through the gut system, qualified for money and everything. Then decision-making came. Oh, well, we have a board of directors. We have partners and everything. I said, fine, let's set up another meeting. So we set up another meeting the second day, spoke with the partners. Everything went well. Claude, we'll call you tomorrow morning. This will be the third meeting. And if you know anything about me, I'm big on closing in the first phone call because guts is about asking questions and qualifying and getting someone so emotionally involved that they want to make an immediate emotional decision. They feel they like and trust you. Maybe you don't have time and availability, a little scarcity. Maybe you've worked with a lot of other people in their business, social proof. You use authoritative and consultative techniques. I've been in business for a while. I offer references. Anyway, make a long story short. Good first meeting, follow-up second meeting, another appointment for the third meeting. And basically, it usually never gets to the third meeting. If I can't close somebody between the first and second meeting, which are usually very close together, it's over. And this is exactly what happened. They ghosted me to name a popular a definition. They went on the witness protection program. We were supposed to follow up the next meeting. I sent a text. They didn't respond. I didn't hear from them. I qualified for money and everything else, but it was probably the money or something like that. So you cannot, when someone is disingenuous or manipulative or just a liar, there's not much you can really do on that. You can qualify, you can get commitments, everything else. And sometimes you just can't close people. But is that my bad or theirs? Bottom line, I always invite people, please fire me. Tell me no right now. You don't have to think about it. Oh, okay. You want to talk to your partners. You want to check my references or something. That's fine. But after you do that, when we speak at 4:30 the next day, can you make a decision? Fine. And so you have continuity, you have commitment and everything, but sometimes people are just people and it's not your fault. You didn't do anything wrong. So you don't have to beat yourself up. But the thing is, are you working smarter than your competition? Because they're just giving presentations. They're giving away, we call it free consulting. They're giving away tons of information. And then they ask for nothing in return. And in this case, this was a prospect for whatever reason. Maybe they got busy. Maybe something happened. Okay, maybe I shouldn't be so judgmental on it. But I didn't hear from them. And on a 1 through 10, in terms of what we call the guts barometer, in terms of urgency, I would say they were a healthy 7. They had a big problem. And I had a solution for that problem. And I could fix that problem in less than 21 days. It was a sales issue. Really easy to fix. But sometimes things just happen. It's not foolproof. Even mentors make mistakes, okay? But I'm on the phones every day. I talk to people on the phone, on Zoom. I text, I email. I really believe in direct communication. And if you want to be successful in business, you have to communicate directly with people, a phone or a Zoom or FaceTime, getting on, or in person, of course. Things are loosening up, okay? We can get more and more in person. But the thing is, If you did everything the right way and you still didn't succeed, you didn't go to the Guts National Bank, don't beat yourself up. You might want to do a little diagnostic. What could I have done better? What would I do different? If I could go back in the time machine, the DeLorean, remember Back to the Future? If I could go back and do it all over again, what would I do? And I do these diagnostics all the time to see, did I do my job right? Could I have done it better? And the consistency is the key in successful sales. I mean, making a lot of money. You want to make a lot of money. You want to be a kitchen table millionaire. You have a good product or service. I know a lot of you are in real estate. All you have to do is speak to a few people using a tested guts sales question-based system with redirection, stroking, nurturing, and all the good things I talk about, and you'll succeed. The consistency is the real key. One of the things I always ask my students, I mentor students in 22 different countries, and I say, how many people did you speak with today? not text, not email, not leave voicemails. How many people did you actually speak with today? Because making that direct connection with people is what is going to make your business succeed. This is, and speaking of success, nobody deserves success more than you good people. You have a great day. Be careful out there. It's a hot summer, but work inside, turn on that air conditioner, make your calls, and you'll see magic happen every time. And if you want more information, go to ClaudeDiamond.com or give me a call. I answer my own phone. That's crazy. Nobody should do that, right? But I do. Why? Because I believe in high customer service and direct accountability. 970-281-5151. Take care. Thanks for joining me.